believe Joshua Pacio defeats Alex Silva tonight.
Judge
Silva, usually very quiet spoken, not one to give predictions, came out 2 days ago and said quite boldly, I will beat Pacio inside of two rounds. Pacio laughed when he heard it. He said, well, you want to do it inside of two? I'll do it inside of one. And they go to ground inside the opening 17 seconds.
I asked Silva if he was going to pull guard. He said, I'm thinking about it. And he just did just that. Got the overhook, slid right into guard. Now he gets to work his magic off his back. Good job by Pacio to escape that. I let him back up.
Indeed. Pacio allows the former champion back to his feet. Bruce Simpson Wushu striking now from Pacio. Good counter right hand there from Alex Silva. Pacio with a polo punch.
Pacio is standing his ground. He's not too concerned with the way that Alex Silva's closing that distance into boxing range. Alex Silva's getting very close. He can touch you with the hands. He might be able to drop down and snatch up a single leg.
We know the improved striking on Silva, particularly with his leg kicks. We saw that against Naito, when he beat Naito with beautiful leg kicks. Step up knee there from Pacio. Open in orthodox stance. Thrusting jab from Pacio. Silva looks for a low single leg. Wild hands there from Little Rock Alex Silva. Pacio looks calm and collected. The young 24-year-old champion. The 37-year-old former champion. Eats an uppercut off the right hand.
Look at the timing of Pacio. These are clean, crisp strikes that he's landing. Everything from the uppercut to the head kick that I'm sure is coming real soon. He is starting to figure out the distance and the speed of Alex Silva.
Silva momentarily switched to southpaw, now back to orthodox. Charges in, clinches up with Pacio. They do a tango. Backed up against the wall here, dropped down for a single leg to Silva.
This is what Silva has to do. He has to chain wrestle. He has to attack the single leg. If he doesn't get it, he's got to float into something else. But he is able to get this. It's not maybe the way that he wants to do it, but he is able to get this contest to the ground.
Is this advantageous for Silva or for Pacio?
Anything on the ground is advantageous for Alex Silva. He is a BJJ world champion who has very incredibly fast submission skills. You make one mistake, you leave one limb exposed, and he will try to take it back home to Singapore.
Mitch, is there a situation where you could see Pacio possibly submitting Silva?
I mean, anything is possible in this game, especially if Pacio starts launching into some of these big head kicks. If he can stumble Alex Silva and then jump on top of him, catch him and as he's discombobulated for a finish, I can see that happening. But in a straight grappling situation, probably not going to happen.
Nice jump turning back kick, aim for the liver from Joshua Pacio, the young champion of the Philippines in the red, the challenger of Brazil in the white. 150 remaining, first round set for five. World Strawweight Championship on the line. Southpaw back to orthodox for Alex Silva. On the balls of his feet, Silva. High kick nicely done, roundhouse off the lead leg, no switch up from Pacio.
How composed Joshua Pacio is. Completely relaxed and calm, just waiting for his moment, picking his shots.
Not rushing, not overextending. He knows the wily veteran that is Alex Silva, and Silva knows all the tricks in the book. Silva even wrote some of the tricks in the book.
Silva competed at one championship, two. 2012, that's how long he's been in this game, man. He's got so much experience. This is his moment. He might not get another shot at the top of the mountain.
Southpaw stance again from Silva, now back to orthodox. Skip up outside, leg kick from the Brazilian. Launch Pacio to go to ground. Pacio says right. With this to the foot of Silva. Quite ready to let the former champion up. Swings the legs a little. Olivia Goff may allow him to stand up in a moment. And up they get. Very big difference in style. The striker, Pacio, the grappler, Silva. Now Silva top position. Could be stuck in the guillotine here. This may be Pacio's chance to sub Alex Silva. For Silva's sake. He's seen it all before. Top position now for the Little Rock.
Silva needs to keep that pressure. He can't allow Joshua Pacio to have any little bit of space. He's able to end this match on top. Nice little attempt to a leg block there. He dives just as the last 10 seconds. I like the strategy coming from Alex Silva, but he's got to do a little bit more work. That's three attempts he's had at a finish at the bottom. He's been on the ground three times, but Joshua Pacio's confidence got to be at an all-time high. Look at this beautiful timing. This is what Alex Silva needs to be concerned with. It's these entries into the takedowns. Pacio is starting to figure out this timing. If he takes another step back, starts launching into uppercuts, and he starts to work the timing of that knee. Here's a guillotine attempt by Alex Silva. Alex Silva was more concerned with passing the legs than protecting his neck. That just goes to show you a little bit about the ground confidence coming from Alex Silva.
They're ready to roll, second round of five. The world strawweight title on the line. Left at screen, the champion, 24-year-old Joshua Pacio. Right at screen, the challenger, former world champion, Alex Silva. Inside the sold-out Mall of Asia Arena in Manila, the Philippines. A magnificent, glittering spectacle. Cauldron. Everyone in the corner of Pacio. As they touch gloves for round two. Very impressive opening stands up from the champion. Overhand right from Silva. High kick from Pacio. Silva locks onto a single leg. Pacio not going to ground. And now puts Silva on his back.
Silva's trying, chasing those legs, cutting after a leg lock. Good job by Pacio to settle down, control the scramble. Now he's in guard. Let's see if Alex Silva starts to push down those legs. Alex Silva has an old school style of BJJ. He likes to pass the guard, get into side control, look for mounts, and then look for one of those arm bars.
Alex Silva, a 100% submission finishing grunt. Every time he has finished an opponent, he's done so via submission. Now, don't forget, Silva said he would finish Pacio inside of 2 rounds. He's got 3 minutes 55 remaining to make it come true. He's stuck in an attempted guillotine choke, but he's out of it. Inside the closed out of Pacio. It was a very bold statement. Unlike anything we've ever heard from Silva. Usually doesn't make predictions, Alex Silva. Usually says what will be. Certainly made a statement. Good finish Pacio inside of 10 minutes.
Good job by Pacio just to kind of control the overhooks, control the head posture of Silva, not letting Silva posture up and start dropping ground and pound, not allowing Silva to work his way past the full guard here of Joshua Pacio. Pacio still looks relaxed and comfortable. Silva's got to push down on that leg, try to work past it.
3 minutes 5 remains. Silva still inside the guard of the Filipino. It's been a mixed bag for Team Lakai on our main card tonight. The win for Danny Kingad, the loss for Edward Filiang. And now the only remaining world champion from Team Lakai, Joshua Pacio, trying to keep the gold in Baguio. Closes the guard again.
You can see the way Silva's trying to shove his head underneath the armpit. He's possibly looking for an arm triangle choke. He's going to get past the legs of Joshua Pacio. Nice little transition here. You can see how he sits up, controls the leg there. It's kind of a modified rubber guard, trying to control the posture of Joshua Pacio.
Feet on hips here from Silva. Now Pacio back to his feet. Silva circles off clockwise. Into the power side of Pacio, got to watch the head kick. The one that spectacularly knocked out Saluta in what was declared the knockout of the year. It was in April of last year, the head kick that came in the fourth round against Saluta. And there it is, an attempt from Pacio. Top position here for Alex Silva Dragon.
Yeah, Silva's doing a good job of getting this match to where he wants, but he's not really doing anything with it once this gets to the ground. And Joshua Pacio's got good defense. They knew they were going to be in these kind of positions, so they drilled it over and over, making sure Pacio could maintain his guard and stay out of danger. And even when Silva does able, you know, to work his way past the guard, that was a triangle position. Pacio chooses to let it go. So just trying to step over the legs into half guard. So they're trying to push that knee down a little bit. Pacio's doing a good job of staying out of danger. Nice job by Silva to float over. Now he's looking for a possible head and arm choke if he can get to the other side. Actually finish it from this position right here. You can still apply that pressure with your shoulder and drive in. You don't have to be fully committed to the other side. You can choke from this position. It's applied even more in full mount. Here comes the squeeze.
Alex Silva now applies the pressure to Joshua Pacio. Can he take the championship belt back to Brazil? Alex Silva. Pacio defending.
Oh, good work by Joshua Pacio to get out of that.
30 seconds remaining for Silva to find a finish inside of 2 rounds as he predicted. And Pacio survived. Silva keeps the Filipino on his back. Silva, who defended the title last time in all four appeals, there was Rene Catalan beating in the second round by arm triangle. Thanks again. It looks like Pacio will get out of the second round. Now go into the third. Not where Silva thought he would be.
I like these entries into leg locks that he's going for. He's slick. He's keeping Joshua Pacio thinking when he hits that ground by attacking those legs. Look at this arm triangle. This was deep. First, he had it in full mount. Joshua Pacio is tough as nails. This is deep right here. This is a black belt level squeeze, ladies and gentlemen. This is not just your average mixed martial artist. This is a world champion black belt level squeeze he's got, and he was able to get out of that.
Black belt squeeze.
That's a huge, huge for the confidence of Joshua Pacio. Alex Silva's taking some big, deep breaths. Both these guys are looking okay, though.
Okay, Mitch, play coach. First of all, if you're in the corner of Pacio, what are you telling him to do?
I want to see Pacio time some more of these shots. Alex Silva's closing that distance. He's trying to get in for the takedown. I want to see Joshua Pacio unload with those knees and uppercuts. As for Alex Silva, he's got to keep doing what he's doing. The more time that he spends on the mat, the more opportunities he has to catch that submission.
Round of five for the Strawweight World Championship. In the red, the champion, 24-year-old Joshua Pacio. In the white, the former champion, tonight the challenger, Little Rock Alex Silva. Forget, folks, to follow us across all your social media platforms at One Championship on YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. Let us know your thoughts so far. Outside of the kick from Pacio. Pacio, the master of inventive and explosive highlight reel finishes. Alex Silva, in the third round, thought he'd beat Pacio inside of two.
I can see Pacio fake that punch and then land a kick. You can see the way Silva's starting to cover up. He's fully shielding himself, and he's kind of blinded from the oncoming attacks. Pacio could land heavy body and leg kicks when he does that.
It's been a long time since we've seen Team Lakai without championship gold. If Pacio loses tonight, that will be the case.
Nice little knee as Alex Silva tried to close that distance. You do not want to allow Joshua Pacio to get comfortable in this range. Look at the jab.
Uppercut there from Pacio. These two men representing the two mega gyms in Asia. Evolve MMA, Alex Silva, Team McGuire, Joshua Pacio. Open for Justo, multitude of world champions across all divisions.
Again, that's you know, unconventional ways to get it to the ground. That's the third time that he's kind of pulled guard to get Joshua Pacio out down, but it works. Now he's got that butterfly hook on that side, so he's going to try to elevate it. Might be looking for the legs again. Good job by Pacio to work his way back up again.
Let's see if Pacio can affect some of the Russian striking now. The escapes from Pacio tonight, the improving escapes of all the Team Lakai combatants.
Man, you would think Harry Houdini is a coach over there at Team Lakai, because these guys vanish into thin air when you try to grab hold of them.
He's left here. Into the power cycle, watch the round kick of Joshua Pacio. Come off the right leg. Downstairs with a jab from Pacio. Silva edging forward, wants to put hands on him, get a takedown, get Pacio possibly on his back.
I'd like to see more kicks coming from Silva. He has no fear of being taken down, so you might as well let go. Some fancy footwork.
Nice defense again there from Pacio. Come on, seeing some leg kicks from Silva. We know he does have them in his arsenal. Highly impactful strikes. Two punch combination from the Brazilian. Ball there from Pacio. Switches from a single to a double. Now up around the waist goes Alex Silva. 1 minute victory remains. Third round of five, Dragon.
Good job by Silva to work his way back up. You can see he went for the single, chain wrestled his way back into a body lock. He might look to pull guard again here. Pacio's takedown defense has been good, except for this pulling guard. That's the only thing that's...
At only 24 years old, so many records already set by Pacio. Most title bouts in one strawweight history. Most submissions in one strawweight history. Second most wins in one strawweight history. And second most finishes in one strawweight history. 15-3 record, a massive 86% finishing rate, 8 subs, 5 knockouts. Beat Rene Catalan by arm triangle last time to defend the title. First, that magnificent head kick knockout in the fourth round against Saruta. We know that Pacio can finish opponents in the deep water in the latter rounds. Close guard from the champion at the moment.
You gotta think the youth advantage that he's got, the 13 years younger that Pacio is, that's going to play in his favor as the match goes on. But now they're starting to get slippery too, so it's going to be even harder for Silva to hold on to Pacio. So that's going to play into the favor of the explosive team of high athlete Joshua Pacio.
25 seconds remaining in what has been a thrilling contest so far. Nice and cool inside the Mall of Asia Arena. We hit about 32 degrees Celsius in Manila today. It's currently 25 degrees outside.
Yes, again.
Which sets it straight starting to form on both these athletes. Jump to him, back kick aims towards the liver of Alex Silva. And there's trying to move the shin around the back of the neck. We go into the penultimate round. A very close contest.
Interesting third round, but a lot of work was done from Joshua Pacio standing. His knees are timed beautifully. The ways that he's able to figure out the distance, as you can see, Silva tries to get in tight, closing. But then Silva says, hey, I got knees of my own. Let me touch you on the chest, see how you like it. Good back and forth action, but the lead that Silva built up in that second round with all that top control, all that grappling dominance, might have started to bleed its way into the third, but Pacio looked good on the feet, landing significant strikes. I'd like to see a little bit more volume come out of Pacio this round. Silva, he's got to pressure forward. I'd like to see some leg kicks coming from Silva, but he's got to let those hands go.
It's the main event of One Championship Fire and Fury from inside the sold-out Mall of Asia Arena in Manila, the Philippines. We're watching folks around the world, broadcast to over 140 countries. Hope you're enjoying all the action. Don't forget, follow us on social media at One Championship on YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. High kick there from Silva. Southpaw starts from the Brazilian. High kick from Joshua Pacio. Switching stances, Silva. Drop down, looking for a takedown, but Pacio in top position.
Beautiful little underhook push down right there from Joshua Pacio to maintain that top position. You know, in these fourth and fifth rounds, you have got to give a slight advantage to the conditioning of Joshua Pacio. These guys regularly run up mountains for their morning runs. Like, just the endurance that these guys are known for. They can push hard all five rounds.
They're always training at altitude, right? Mitch Baggio is up there in the hills.
Yes, it is.
What altitude is Baggio City at?
It's 11,000 feet.
Could be wrong.
Put me up on Twitter.
Looking for a downward elbow, Pacio, from inside the guard of Alex Silva. A little bit of damage under the right eye around the orbital of Silva. That was mostly incurred in the first round from the striking of Pacio. One foot on hips here from Alex Silva. Controlling the posture of the Filipino, the world champion in the red trunks. Which is consulting Google at the moment to find out the elevation of Pacquiao City, just to clarify. Pacio, can he get the arms free here and drop some leather, some anvils on the face of Alex Silva? Silva trying to lift him. To no avail, though, for the former world champion. Butterfly guard now for Alex Silva. A lot of options available. Back to a foot on hips here for Silva.
You can see that Alex Silva's having a hard time getting a hold on Joshua Pacio because of the slipperiness, that this sweat after four rounds is starting to build up. But Alex Silva's constantly looking for different attacks. He's got so much mat time in his life. He's so dangerous, especially off his back. But that sweat, you can see Joshua Pacio was able to pull out because the legs are slippery now.
Crowd loving the chant that Pacio may be able to strike now. Genuflect position back onto his feet for Pacio. And the boss Olivia Cross says to Alex Silva, stand up. By the way, Mitch, Pacquiao City 5,000 feet above sea level. Jab two, another jab there from Pacio. Turns the knuckles in on the lead hook as Pacio. And Silva comes forward. Knee to a right hand. High kick from Silva. They came close for the Brazilian. Body shot from Pacio. Silva edges forward, goes the outside thigh kick. Right bent trade jab. Left hand from Silva, didn't have the mustard behind it.
I gotta say that Joshua Pacio is putting a lot of the critics of Team Lakai to rest. There has been so much talk about the lack of ground game coming from Team Lakai, but he is showing a definitely elevated level of grappling. He's been able to stop all of Alex Silva's attacks on the ground. Look at it, piecing him up with that jab. Beautifully done on that straight right hand.
Oh, high kick was spinning back to the left hand. What a combination from Pacio. A beautiful combination. Now a double leg, and now a single leg from Silva. And Pacio defending. Silva wants the Filipino, the world champion, on his back.
Look at Alex Silva, he's trying to float over, but a good job by Pacio to maintain that guard. But look at that reversal. Now Joshua Pacio's on top. Alex Silva does a nice little hip escape to retain half guard.
This is a thrilling contest. This highly educated Philippines crowd enjoying the ground battle between Pacio and Silva.
You can see how Silva tries to go underneath that leg, trying to attempt deep half, looking for a submission. But Joshua Pacio, very well educated on the ground game, able to keep those heavy hips and prevent Silva from going anywhere.
Feet on hips from Silva. Trying to sub out Joshua Pacio. 20 seconds remains, fourth round of five.
Little elevator sweep there, beautifully done. Once he got that butterfly hook in, he was able to elevate Pacio over and reverse the position. Now he's gonna push that leg down, end up in mount.
Once again, doesn't get the full note from Pacio, the champion, back to his feet. Final seconds, we are going into the deepest of deep water. We're going in for the fifth and final round.
The scrambling of Joshua Pacio is intense. Look at him, timing beautifully done, leans back, little hand exchange there as Pacio floats backwards. Beautiful little knee to a right hand, but then Silva throwing a head kick of his own. Pacio backs up, and beautiful little shoulder roll from Alex Silva to avoid being decapitated by that head kick.
A little bit of Run DMC, tricky between rounds from our DJ here. And I'll tell you what, Joshua Pacio has been full of tricks in this title defense so far. 5 more minutes remaining. Can Silva get the title back, or will Joshua Pacio retain it? No one has left their seat inside the sold-out Mall of Asia Arena. They're on the edge of their seats for this one. The final remaining Team Lakai world champion, Joshua Pacio. One of two Filipino world champions on the one championship roster. The other being in attendance, the heavyweight world champion, Brandon Vera. And a roundhouse kick to the ribcage there from Pacio. Jumping knee! Jumping knee! And a takedown from Silva.
His timing on that knee is something spectacular. That was a jumping knee.
explosive start from Joshua Pacio. Our top position for Alex Silva. Silva is so cunning, so wily, a veteran. As Mick said earlier, he's been here since one championship, number two. 37-year-old former champion, 24-year-old current champion. And what a thrilling show they put on so far. Closed guard here from Joshua Pacio.
You gotta wonder at this point, how did the judges see it? It's been so close. There's been a lot of top control coming from Alex Silva, but we're not seeing ground control. He's not really advancing his position in a lot of these ground grappling exchanges. He's not passing the guard. He's not working into mount. He's been held in one position. That's inside the guard of Pacio. But has Pacio been doing enough work on the feet to push that far ahead? It's been an interesting tactical strategy by both these athletes so far to see how things have played out in the first four rounds. And now we're approaching the fifth round. It could come down to this.
You know, on his one championship debut back in 2012, at one championship number two, Alex Silva was beaten by a member of Team Lakai in Jay Hayastakwia.
See that Alex Silva has been attempting these, trying to pull guard, trying to drop down to his back. You know, you gotta wonder, are the escapes of Joshua Pacio, the way that he is defending, gonna weigh that heavily in the judges' eyes? In my mind, probably not, because they like to see them as faceless athletes, as, you know, not paying attention to anything of their skill set and just weighing what happens right in front of them.
2 minutes 25 remains, fifth and final round. Fake there from Silva. Thought about a sidekick, Wushu style, did Pacio. Silva southpaw stance, edging forward the Brazilian now, switches back to his preferred orthodox stance. Pacio thought about sliding with a jolt jab. Leads him with a hook instead. It is still anyone's for the taking, 120 seconds remaining. Leg kick there from Silva, jump turning back kick! Hoping to find the liver of Alex Silva. The one that Kevin Ballion famously caught Andrew Leone with. That sent Leone across the ring some 15 paces. Single leg knock on here from Silva, hunting for a takedown. Hopscotch time for Joshua Pacio. Still can't get him down, now he does. Top position, half guard for Alex Silva.
Nice single leg takedown for Silva. He's got 90 seconds to do work. He might be slightly behind in the judges' scorecards if he's taking striking superiority into factor. And that's kind of the only thing that we're really seeing from Pacio. We're seeing a lot of top control. He has been able to land a couple of takedowns, but I don't know if pulling guard really counts as a takedown as well, because you're not controlling the opponent's hips. That single leg takedown was a takedown because he pulled him down, secured the hips, and was able to stay on top. But he's not showing ground control. He's not passing the guard to Pacio, as Pacio gives a thumbs up to his fellow Colombians.
Thumbs up to the crowd for the confident young world champion, Joshua Pacio. What improvements Pacio has made over the last 18 months. Almost unrecognizable, especially with his ground game. Nice elbow there, and Pacio forced to quickly count his teeth. Looking for the ground and pound Silva. Postures up now the Brazilian. Gets elevated by Pacio momentarily. 30 seconds to go. Half guard position. They're screaming for Pacio. What has Silva got left with 20 seconds remaining? Can he get the right leg out? Can he pass guard? Go to side control. No, he stays inside a half guard. Has he got a final squeeze? What's he got here, Alex Silva? Yes, again. We're going to go down the judges in the middle. Comes away from the left hand to Silva. Now switches to the right hand of the body. Then up to the hand. Now it's unloaded.
Going to the judges' scorecards. The strawweight title tilt. In that fifth round, we saw a few takedowns coming from Alex Silva. He was able to lock in the body lock, stay nice and tight, get this match to where he wanted. But when he was able to get it there, was he doing enough in the eyes of the judges? Look at Joshua Pacio slowly backing up, goes for the jumping knee, gives up the leg in the process, and that puts him in a position where he's able to get taken down. Another single leg takedown. But in that instance, he was able to control the hips and get on top. But Pacio plays to the crowd, gives us a thumbs up. He's not really in a submission attempt. He's just kind of playing to the crowd and telling everybody that he's okay.
Okay, let's go to Tom Lau with our decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present the belt for this match, we have country marketing head of Grab Philippines, Mr. Ralph John Cavuna. And now, ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. Judge number one calls this contest in favor of the blue corner. Judge number two calls this contest in favor of the red corner. And judge number three calls this contest in favor of your winner by split decision. And still one Strawweight World Champion, Pacio.
Championship gold stays in the Philippines. The reign of gold continues.
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.